Have you ever thought of getting a penile prosthesis? It is an effective surgical way to treat erectile dysfunction and responsive to other therapies. In this video, I will give you some pros and cons for and against prosthesis placement. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Let's dive right in. Penile prostheses for treating erectile dysfunction have been around for quite a while now. Already in the 1930s, there were attempts to implant rib cartilage, but it wasn't before 1973 when the small carry-on prosthesis was introduced to the market and paved the way for the two types of devices which are available today, the malleable and the inflatable prosthesis. But I think it is safe to say the inflatable device is the standard of care dominating the market because it resembles the real thing. The penis only gets firm when needed and is soft otherwise. The latest development is the three-piece inflatable penile prosthesis. The first models of this new type were introduced roughly 10 years ago. Here are some examples. An inflatable prosthesis consists of two inflatable corporeal cylinders which replace the original cavernous bodies. There is a fluid reservoir which is placed in the lower abdomen and a small scrotal pump. With the help of that pump, the fluid from the reservoir is released into the prosthesis for erection. After use, the fluid flows back into the reservoir. It sounds very easy, and if it works, it is. However, a lot of thinking is necessary before a decision for a prosthesis is taken, because this step will be life-changing. And although satisfaction rates are high, there are still patients who are not satisfied. And should this happen to you, it could be a life-changing step to the worse, not to the better. It all depends on patient selection. On UroChannel, I upload valuable information on urological and sexological topics. Knowledge it took many years to acquire. I cover topics you won't easily find elsewhere on YouTube. If you like my content and think it could also be valuable to others, you can help to spread the word. Subscribe to UroChannel and hit the like button so the algorithm knows that it should show it to other people as well. If you are a super fan, consider supporting me by becoming a member of the Above Average Club. I would be very happy. Who is a candidate for prosthesis placement? Erectile dysfunction after surgery for prostate cancer would be a classic, or severe forms of Peyronie's disease, or erectile dysfunction resistant to any kind of non-surgical treatment. Gender reassignment surgery is a growing field, and formation of a neophallus has driven technical advances. Recently, a three-piece prosthesis was introduced especially designed for the neophallus. A review in the Journal of Sexual Medicine from 2019 found an overall satisfaction rate of 85% and higher after prosthesis placement. Sexual quality of life was improved in both patients and their partners. However, keep in mind that prosthesis placement may not be once and for all. Surgical and non-surgical minor and major complication rates combined may be as high as 20 to 30%, but are often reported significantly lower. Infection is one of the problems. Protrusion could be another one, just to name two examples. Besides, a prosthesis may not last for a lifetime. In a large retrospective study, only 68.5% of the prostheses were still working after 10 years, and 59.7% after 15 years. So 3 out of 10 prostheses will have to be replaced within 10 years, and 4 out of 10 within 15 years. Even after replacement, satisfaction rates were still good, as you can see in this figure. Very interestingly, 90% would recommend prosthesis surgery despite only moderate overall satisfaction. In the end, it comes down to patient selection. Obesity with a body mass index above 30 has been associated with poor satisfaction rates. Patients over 70 years could also be at risk for lower satisfaction rates. Certain personality traits pose a risk. Unrealistic expectations regarding the result are a big problem. It may be of interest for you to know the current global trends in prosthesis placement. Most penile prostheses are implanted in the US. During the period from 2005 to 2012, nearly 86% of the procedures were performed in the US. Germany was number two and accounted for 2.3% of the procedures, followed by the UK with 2.1%. Although there is a visible trend worldwide towards more procedures being performed, the number of men deciding for prosthesis placement are low. Of the men with erectile dysfunction, only 2 to 3% undergo surgery. I guess it has also to do with culture. There is definitely a difference between America and Europe in how health problems are perceived and how they are solved. In my experience, most men are very reluctant when it comes to penile prosthesis surgery. One has to balance advantages against risks, and without doubt, getting a prosthesis is a life-changing procedure, for the better or for the worse. Nobody can foresee the future, so it is not easy to generally be for or against it. The decision has to be based on the individual parameters. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.